spell on you. Because you're mine.
Watch this, then, homie.
Stop the things you do.
Whoa!
Bloody brave, the bloody brave. Bring back the bloody brave. Set aside my jukebox. Fucking freaking me
Well, you're going to see it with your own two eyes. This real live Staten Island mermaid right here is going to show you glass walking. That's right, folks. She is pain proof. You will see this with your own two eyes.
Thank you.
gentlemen. Look at that. Talk about a dangerous balancing act right here. We're sitting in absurd Coney Island USA Circus Sideshow. Ladies and gentlemen, we want to welcome you all to the evening. We'll be turning the microphone over here.
Far too hot in there to keep it on all night, but it helps the aesthetic. Welcome to Bloody Brains at the Henson Carriage House.
Welcome!
Did anyone watch the BBC yesterday where the House of Commons in London went crazy? And the chairman, the guy who gavels 400 snitty British politicians, has to quiet them, and he's got this vibrato to his voice going, "Order! Let's have some order!" At this private party, we don't expect order. We encourage your weird fantasies and trying to fulfill them. This is not a public performance. You are not in Coney Island. You were not on Broadway. You are producers, ladies and gentlemen. And you can use your dollars, whether they are small dollars or big dollars, to produce amazing theater and not just mediocre theater. And we're doing it tonight. By the end of the night, we'll be at about 95% of our crowdfunding goal. And thanks to you, and only thanks to you, we are going to pull off the most ambitious piece of weirdo theater that we've ever attempted at Coney Island. It not only is a three-hour, three-act rock opera, there are three murders, there's a suicide, two heads are cut off with chainsaws. Jayne Mansfield's death is reenacted, which means a convertible crashes, her head is decapitated, her brain opens and flies through the air and lands inside of a jukebox where three other brains are inside the jukebox. And at the end of Act Two, all the main characters are dead, and the audience has been splattered with brain matter.
All right.
And then there's Act Three after everybody's dead, and that only happens because you tonight have paid for a giant Wurlitzer jukebox puppet that can not only eat brains, it can fly. I hear it weighs 50 pounds, and we're going to figure out how to make that happen. Right, Sam?
Yep.
Right, Jennifer? Yes, we are. We can do it because we are in this room with resonates with the vibrations of puppetry, American popular culture. It happened here. And we're so honored that the Henson family is so open to puppetry in all different manifestations in New York City, and including this one.
Yeah.
So thank you, Heather.
Pay
attention! Order!
Just in case we need it. A quick word about where we are. This is the Henson Carriage House. In the 1960s, Jim Henson had a workshop right next door, and in the late 70s into the 80s acquired this building, This was a photo studio for pretty much most photo ops that you saw in print for Muppets were shot in this room. PSAs were shot in this room. At award ceremonies, if someone had to dial in and do something quick on screen, they would shoot it here. For those of you who are fans of John Denver, once upon a time, John Denver did a Muppets Christmas holiday special, but there was also the Rocky Mountain holiday.
Yeah, they were live at the Rocky Mountains, right?
They were. All gathered around a campfire. John
yeah,
Denver
I saw that. It
Muppets.
Was filmed at the Rocky Mountains, right?
That was filmed right here.
No shit.
So this is a pretty magical space. Art happens in here. You can do so much with it. This currently is the home of Ibex Puppetry, which is Heather Henson's company, Jim's youngest daughter. Some of her team are here tonight to make sure that we are comfortable, so we are super grateful to them for welcoming us. They have a lot of exciting programs all the time. Ibex, you know, under Heather's direction, every year has a handmade Puppet Dreams film series. They produce three original puppet, short puppet films every year. They have public environmental puppet performances focusing on environmental causes, specifically with cranes, crane migration, and the livelihood. We're just pleased as punch to be here. And Coney Island USA, known for the Mermaid Parade, for the sideshow, for burlesque, for so much. Some of us know, but not everyone knows.
Not too many people know.
Not too many people know, but now more know, and now more will know. Coney Island USA is also home to Funhouse Philosophers, which is Dick's resident theater company. They've
Weird
been doing
shit.
Plays for quite a while, years. You might have seen before the bubbles, there were projections of...
Yes, we charge people to look at bubbles for 2 hours. It's very avant-garde.
Yes. Plays like Dead End Dummy. Plays like...
Do we have a slideshow? That...
There was. I mean, I can run it back. Where's that slideshow?
Yeah, it's nice to see we have a body of work. And we've developed a company, so... Pnk Vlvt Wtch, who was just playing some of the songs. Where are you? It wrote the music for Bloody Brains in a Jukebox. I wrote the libretto. The incredible Jennifer Miller is directing. Sam Wilson is taking care of the incredible brain-eating Jukebox puppet. And get this, the concept. So we've been building this theater company. We've got a body of work. We've got good artists to work with. So we needed a challenge. Oh my God, the challenge is to take the mixed aesthetics, if you know your weird experimental theater, of the bread and puppet theater of New York City and Vermont, going back to anti-Vietnam parades in the streets up in Vermont. The Bread and Puppet Theater is incredible by itself, but mix that with the work of Circus Amok, a transgender circus that tours the parks of New York City. Mix that with the weirdness and freakiness of Coney Island, USA. And then aspire to the campiness and the influence of the ridiculous theatrical. Then self-consciously try and rip off and create the commercial energy of Little Shop of Horror and Rocky Horror Picture Show. And that's what we're trying to do and what you've paid to do. And if you come in November and like the results, think of yourselves as weirdo theater producers.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah. 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 Many of you have already found the crowdfunding page that Dick mentioned, and if you made a $50 donation, you already have a ticket to opening night. So keep that in mind. Dick is a graduate of the Yale School of Drama.
So we're in
professional hands with this production. Before we get on with the evening, we have the first half that you're going to see.
The evening has an order.
Yes, in the order of the evening, the first half will be acts related to both Funhouse Philosophers and to Bloody Brains, the rock opera. The second half will be some of our friends representing Coney Island USA. A little circus sideshow, a little magic. So there's a lot to see, so we want to get on with it. But throughout the night, you may have already checked in with our Bloody Brains stage manager, and
there's a raffle! You can win fantastic things worth millions of dollars!
Our stage manager, Sarah Minascaro, is guarding a treasure trove.
How much are tickets?
Prizes. Well, tickets, let me tell them what they get. Okay. I know what they're going to get what they're in for.
Get things?
You have an opportunity, if you buy into this raffle, to win three pair of full-priced MoMA tickets. That's Museum of Modern Art.
What's that worth?
They're worth $25 a piece. What? Not terrible. You are welcome to a pair of tickets to Puppets Come Home Part 2. This is a Halloween puppet show I'm producing on October 18th and 19th.
That's like $30?
$30?
How much is a ticket?
Yeah, 15.
15, so that's a $30 value on top of your MoMA value.
That's right.
On top of what else?
On top of selling our raffle tickets and stage managing our show, Sarah Minascaro is raffling off three tarot readings. If you're into the occult and the mystical, she can give you some guidance. We have three Coney Island USA Mermaid Parade t-shirts.
Oh, those are worth $25 each.
That's it. Three vintage Coney Island genuine postcards.
Easily worth $15 each.
That's right. Priceless, but Dick brought himself to bring them to the people. You have one funny face mask.
What do those sell for?
They sell for $40.
Wow. Oh, you gotta be in this raffle, but you gotta be in it to win it.
Last but not least, we have a super generous contribution from the artist in residence at Coney Island USA, Marie Roberts, who is seated right here.
Marie,
can I grab one of these? These are original works by Marie. We have the classic sideshow, Alive. We have a skeletal mermaid. There are two other different pieces in the back. You can win all of this and more if you buy into the raffle. At any point during the entertainment, if you want to sneak to the back and buy tickets, that's fine.
How much are those tickets?
Tickets are one ticket for $2. Three tickets for $5.
Three for $5.
Ten for $10.
Oh, that's what I'm getting.
Oh, the price comes down.
Yeah. And for $20, you get a body wrap, where you get to take as many tickets as wrap around the widest part of your anatomy or your partner's anatomy.
Look how many tickets behind you get for a body wrap.
Pay for a body wrap.
So you know what to do. If the spirit moves you, you can win big. We'll give you another chance. We'll take a short break.
Line up, get your tickets, but do it in an orderly fashion.
Yeah, at any point, although the
But let's entertain the...
Yeah, you'll get an intermission to rush the table.
They're theater backers.
They're theater backers.
Don't let them get bored. Put on the show.
Let's see some entertainment. So, first up... Oh, the last item you should have all received when you at the front entrance. Don't forget to pick up one of these cards. What is this?
What is this?
This is a Coney Island Funny Face Build Your Own Jumping Jack puppet.
Oh, yeah.
And if you do it correctly, it looks like this.
Yay!
Everyone is entitled to one. Grab one before you go. They're in the back. Gretchen Van Lent, the artistic director of Drama of Works, working the doors, holding them up right now. Is that it? Man, I think that's it. So without any further ado, folks, last year's Funhouse Philosophers production of The Education of Al Capone, as if told by Jimmy Durante, featured Jimmy Durante, and he's here with us today. So I'm going to pass the floor to him. Folks, Jimmy Durante.
Hello, everybody. Hello, hello. You may have noticed that I look a little bit different. First, on account of I grew this mustache to enter this into this year's beard and mustache competition at Coney Island USA. And secondly, to make it look even bigger, I got myself a schnozziotomy. It was a nosendectomy. Any way you slice it, I paid through the nose. I know, these aren't dad jokes, folks. These are easily great-grandfather jokes.
Jimmy!
Honestly. I just learned to play this song for this dick, so let's hear it for him, all right? Yeah. The street and went to delight us. Some gang comes to fight us. We don't call the cops on the beat. We stand each man to our place and tells them right to their face, go on home, your mother's calling, your father got caught in the garbage can. Go on home, your mother's bawling, they've come to collect your old man. One day my sweet mother said, fetch your dear brother, he'd been gone since yesterday noon. So I made a beeline as fast as a feline to old man McGinty's saloon. And just as I burst through the door, the bartender stopped me and roared, go on home, your mother's calling, they just found your dad in the wash machine. Go on home, your mother's bawling, she'll never get the laundry out clean. Now there was this man, you see, he loved the bees, they were his closest friends. But when he sat upon their hive, they stung him in the end. What was that?
This song is not politically
correct. Oh no, there's no good politics about it. It starts about a girl that's so dumb.
How dumb is she?
Do you want to know?
Yeah.
She was so dumb, they had to burn down the elementary school to get her out of third grade. I know, right?
You can do worse.
I might look simple, but I want you to know I've been to college. I'm full of knowledge. I'm running home with brainy men and then my wisdom I show. But when this clever girl's around, I get up and go. Those educated babies are a bore. So I say, as I said many times before, you wanna hear about it?
Yeah.
Oh, the dumber they come, the better I like them, cause the dumb ones know how to make love. A Weisenheimer has you meet a folks when you call, but a dumb one always leaves you waiting down in the hall. All the dumbbells I've met, they won beauty prizes. They look like angels sent from above. A clever girl might want to know if you mean to wed, but a dumb one never digs snakes are looking dead far ahead. That's why the dumber they come, the better I like them, cause the dumb ones know how to make love. Did you like that last note? I got it from Bing Crosby. He was fucking happy to get rid of you. While I'm on the subject of our current surroundings, have you tried the beer in this joint? It's like trying to have sex in a canoe.
What's that like?
It's fucking close to water. I got a joke for you. Hold on. What's the difference between your wife and your chosen occupation? After 30 years, your job's probably still gonna suck. Alright, what's the difference between getting a Hummer and taking it in the back door? The Hummer might make your day, but taking it from behind's gonna make your whole week. Do I get any Italians in the audience? Any folks in the Ginzo persuasion? Alright, yeah. Do we got any Tonys? Any Vinnies? Any Kevins? You watch your ass, Kevin. I got one just for the Italians tonight, all right? If you got a gizzard and I got a gizzard, what do we got? That's right, we got a gizzard each. That's right, you got two people actually laughing and the rest of them just pretending. But that's okay, because I got a million of them. Kering, kering. That's what I do. That was supposed to be a sweet chord. I'm gonna have to give it back. Thank you so much.
Well, Jimmy Durante.
Hey.
So, next up, moving forward from the Education of Al Capone, for Bloody Brains, we have lyrics written by Dick Zigun. We have music composed by Pnk Vlvt Wtch, aka Nikos Brisco. So I'll pass it to Nikos, who will give us a sample of what we can expect in Bloody Brains.
So 3 hours worth of music was definitely a tremendous challenge, and I'm happy that Dick is always throwing crazy stuff out there and challenging me to fucking try to get out of the box, do something different, do something unfucking bearable.
No, this was really an amazing experience writing the music for this show. And then there's four characters in the play. And, I'm so excited at what's actually gonna happen that we really are gonna get the chance to do this and have these characters come to life. So writing these songs just to get them out and get them together.
And a live rock band on stage.
With a live rock band, which is amazing. We always wanted that, and now we got that. So Dick, the first thing I would like to play is just to start. This is a small sample of some of the music. Track one, The Cure for Cancer. Do you want to set this up?
This is the opening song. So imagine the perfect Hollywood version of a mid-century home in the Hollywood Hills, where two very wealthy doctors live. One is a brain surgeon who just happens to look exactly like Sidney Poitier. And right. His wife is the foremost 1950s authority on body language, and she happens to look just like Audrey Hepburn. And this is the opening song.
Oh, my house has picture windows, swimming pool out in the back. Why wife and I are wealthy doctors. Best damn lifestyle, that's a fact. I am the first black brain surgeon, married to a Belgian PhD. Her book's a number one bestseller, Body Language, You and Me. How lucky we be. Oh, our pad is picture perfect. Private patient entrance in the back. Man and wife, top LA doctors. Hollywood lifestyle, that's a fact. We should mix martinis. We should throw a party. After all, it's New Year's Eve. Happy 1959. We should call our two best friends, the brilliant cancer research team. Hello, darling. What's up, buddy? Join us for cocktails. Drop by for some drinks. All work and no play. What's that you say? All work and no play. What's that you say? You discovered the cure for cancer. They discovered the cure for cancer! Are you serious? Drive over, tell us right now, you're not kidding. Speed up as fast as you can. They hang up the phone. Who's coming to dinner? Just the cure for cancer. Who could have guessed? Who is coming to dinner? Our guests are really the best. Happy 1959, the next Nobel Prize winners. Happy 1959. Time Magazine's next man. Woman of the Year, 1959, the most important brains in the world. Come on, you know the year, 1959, who's coming to our house, you'll never guess, in 1959, just the two smartest brains in the whole wide world.
Okay, so the cancer research couple, the two smartest brains in the world, their car crashes driving over. If you're a brain surgeon and your two best friends are there and they're dying, but they know the cure for cancer, you got to think about saving those brains. It gets a little Frankenstein-y.
Think about it. It's just completely logical that you just put yourself in that place.
Where you got to do it. Especially if your mid-century modern home in the Hollywood Hills has a private operating room.
In 1959, because like mid-century modern, that shit's still cool. Thank you.
dotted line on forehead. Here's the jaw to save the brain. Rev up the saw, scalp the skull, remove the brain. We owe it to the world.
Comatose bodies come from a overdose situation in a look-alike contest, and one of the bodies resembles Jayne Mansfield. The other looks like Jackie Coogan, who played Uncle Fester. The brains get transplanted into the new bodies. The operation's successful, the bodies revive, they can talk, but they don't remember or refuse to remember the cure for cancer, blah, 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 blah. Act one, there's an earthquake that destroys Hollywood. Act two, we jump 20 years ahead to Needles, California on the Nevada border in 1979, where older beatnik Jackie Coogan, a garage mechanic, is running a gas and grill, the state line gas and grill, with an older plunker, punker, Jayne Mansfield, waitress. They're pretty much living a hideout lifestyle, bored in the desert, when Sidney Poitier and Audrey Hepburn drive up in a Mercedes convertible. Long story short, lots of people get shot. It goes real Sam Peckinpah. There's blood everywhere.
Pharmaceutical grade cocaine rubbed all over people's assholes.
Yeah, that does happen.
Multiple fucking assholes.
Anyway, brain matter's in the jukebox, and Jayne Mansfield finally, in her LSD trip, freaks out about the bloody mess.
But now we're in space.
Oh,
track not... 14.
Oh, sorry. So that was act two. And then
that
she
was just
dies,
act two,
and
my friend.
There's atom bombs and flying saucers. Then we jump ahead to 2099, the last day.
The last day on Earth was actually
a boring day.
It was like nobody was coming into the sideshow. We were just sitting there, you know.
So what song are you going to do?
Track 14.
Which one is that?
Alien Concepts.
The jukebox with intelligence inside, the jukebox able to dance, fly, sing, speak, is beamed up to a UFO when this song happens, with alien doctors examining the anthropomorphic jukebox in the UFO.
It's basically a real live alien probe.
Beep, beep.
Alien Concepts.
conclusion. Little gray alien doctors, are we well adjusted? Are we healthy? What are our chances? Meet me, your story is similar. Meet me to other stories. Meet me, friends, craft a story. Meet me, metamorphosis. Meet me, man becomes a cockroach.
Sideshow performer, academic professor at Pratt, artistic director and founder of Circus Amok, folks. Yeah. This is Jennifer Miller.
Take these bloody brains and body parts that will soon be flowing, flying through space, and see if I can make them fly through space.
And she knew it!
Into the jukebox and out into the world. The jukebox that was once a jukebox becomes a sentient being, releasing all consciousness into outer space. Our only hope for the future starts right here with the objects flying. Bloody brain, bloody head, Left hand. Drum roll, please. No, I thought it was a really good idea, and I want to try it again. I didn't rehearse, because now I direct, so I don't have to rehearse, but I oh, one more try. One more try. The brains will be juggled and eaten. All right. So if any of you are planning to audition, please, I hope that you can juggle and eat cauliflower. I'm thrilled. It's a herb. It's sci-fi. It's more. It's grand guignol. It's funny. It's serious. It's intellectual. It's stupid. It's campy. It's fabulous. And we'll see you all there. And now for a little trailer. Sam Wilson coming to the stage. Sam Wilson!
We got a fucking trailer for you.
Sam Wilson designs for makes theater with the box cutter theater.
Watch those lights.
Bread and puppet theater. Designed for Circus Amok, all kinds of things. And she's created here a little something to let you know what's about to happen.
Coming this November.
My last foray into performing before I have to just be a director. One last time. Of Circus Amok, which is not a transgender circus, but it's kind of cool. Getting
a penis pump. So, Dr. Hepburn and Dr. Poitier decide to let these creatures go and live the life they were meant to live. Flash forward, 1979. Needles, Arizona. That's right, Coogan and Mansfield have made a nice little life for themselves. They own a diner and a roadside attraction, the State Line Gas and Grill. And then, that evening, Hepburn and Poitier are driving around. I think it's time for a cocktail, it's about 5 o'clock, when they run into their old friends! All hell breaks loose! Mansfield shoots Hepburn. Poitier shoots Coogan. There's a standoff. Everyone's injured. They take all of the drugs in the first aid kit. They bleed. They trip. They hug. They blow bubbles. And then, in an instant, a good trip gone bad, Mansfield kills Poitier. Then she drives a car into the jukebox, killing herself. And in this whole event, all the brains end up flying through space into the jukebox. And declares four brains are better than one, and three genders are better than two, three sexes are better than two. What will we learn from this jukebox?
I have a beard, Sam. I don't know.
Climate change.
The play to find out.
The media. Nationalism.
Consciousness.
Gender.
Borders.
All these things.
Sci-fi.
That's
future.
Right. You can
room.
See it. It's coming soon. To Sideshows by the Seashore.
Chance to stretch your legs. There's still some hors d'oeuvres, some beverage. It'll take about 10 minutes and then come back for some more entertainment. So
there's
our sideshow.
More raffle tickets.
Oh, yeah, now is the time.
Raffle tickets.
At the table. We have a lot of goodies to win. Get those tickets. See you in 10 minutes.
What are the reactions? I'm sure you get a lot of talk there.
How's everyone doing? Who's watching? If anybody watching, let me give you a shout out. We'll hang out for 10 minutes. As we are in intermission.
Water.
If you want to sell on the internet.
Oh, you have an audience.
You have an audience here.
Hey, so, I'm glad you're having a good time, and I'm glad you're checking out what it's like to be a producer of Weirdo Theater. And you've still got a chance, because our deadline to get the budget together is September 15th. So Ed here is going to tell
yes.
you.
The link is down below.
Facebook, the link is
down below the video right
you
now.
You can give us $5. You can give us $1,000. You just like Zero Mostel in the producers. You can become a producer. It's that easy.
It's that easy.
You just watch this. You have a good time. You go to your computer. And you donate a buck, or you get drunk and you hit some zeros.
Hells yeah.
So it's $100, or it's $10,000. We'll use it wisely.
Absolutely, Dick.
Thanks for watching.
Thanks for producing.
And we'll see you in November.
Yeah. You heard it, folks. November. That's right. Just a month away. Are you guys entertained? You guys better be entertained. Oh, you're not entertained. All right. So, we're in a bit of an intermission now. So you guys could have talked to Dick, you know. Why? I don't know why guys got all quiet all of a sudden. No need to be all quiet all of a sudden. No need to be all quiet all of a sudden, guys. Well, so many great broadcasts here at Music of Curiosities. Well, who's in the house? Talk to me. You can talk to me right now. I'll show. Linda's in the house watching from Long Island with Dave. Guess what? Thanks to the power of the internet, Linda, you are here. Linda, welcome. Thanks to the power of the internet, you are here. I'm glad you tuned on in, Linda. You couldn't let a performance go like this and not have it documented for you guys. This place just oozes history. You can just feel the history in this room that we're in right now. So many memories from all of our collective childhoods in this very room. It's kind of amazing. Right here in the Upper East Side. And we're only halfway through the show, Linda. So you got some time. Get some snacks. Grab yourself a beer or a glass of wine, whatever you so choose. Well, we're a little bit of Coney Island right here on the Upper East Side, which is interesting, to say the least. Oh my God, we got some great acts about to come up momentarily here. Oh my goodness. A whole evening of entertainment. Live, right? We're live right now. You want to talk to these folks? You can talk to these folks. We're just hanging out.
Right?
You know?
Not too bad for a
not
crazy
too bad.
Speakeasy
no.
evening.
No.
In Manhattan.
Right? Upper East Side.
Right?
Somewhere.
No.
Yeah, we were cool with the location.
You don't have to kill somebody.
Yeah, I might have to kill a few of these people in here.
They'll have to pay thousands of dollars.
Yeah, they'll have to pay thousands of dollars to the Russian mafia.
Oh, Music of Curiosities, love you. Look for this at Coney Island USA.
That's right.
It's basically www.coneyisland.com. That is Coney Island USA's website. Find out about this.
The link is actually down below in the description.
Oh, it's in the description.
Yeah.
I mean, you may be able to. I don't know yet. I can't speak out of turn, but maybe we'll broadcast some of this.
Yeah. Maybe.
For those of you who are out of town.
Yeah.
And for the time travelers.
And for the time travelers.
In 2008, you motherfucking time travelers. We know you're there. Little gray alien.
I'm glad you're enjoying the show, Dave. You used to live on 69th Street between 1st and 2nd. That's like two blocks away from here. Aren't you happy you got out of the Upper East Side? Not my favorite neighborhood, but hey. It's nice to get out of Brooklyn sometime, right? But I'm glad you guys are enjoying the show, having a ball. Share this out. Share this out on your Facebook feeds or your Instagrams, or if you're on that evil Twitter, share it out on the Twitter. And of course, you can always watch this on the replay. We can always feel free to watch this on the replay. I was so close to the brains. It was amazing. Wait, actually, it's right here. Isn't that delicious? I thought that was cotton candy at first, but I was being naive.
I was hoping to juggle any different.
I know. Right next time. Oh, you gave up a rent control. Oh, what the hell, Linda? You gave a rent control apartment on the Upper East Side? Yeah, I would say no to that, too. But then again, I don't know. Everything's so weird up here in Uptown. Oh my goodness, they have a rent-controlled apartment. That's craziness. I think I'm going to probably die in my rent-controlled apartment. I'll probably... Who else is in the room? Who else is in the room? We have Linda. We have Dave watching out there in... You guys are in Brooklyn or in Queens? I always forget. I think you guys are in Brooklyn, right? We're here. We got battery. We're here, baby. A couple of the lights got moved around. A couple of these really cool canister lights here. There's little old me. Lots of snacks to be had. Kind of amazing. Lots of snacks to be had. See, you could have came out here, Linda, but then again, don't know if you guys had the time to come out here. I'm literally came down from work. Went home from work. Took a 15-minute nap. Oh, even better out there in Glen Cove, Long Island. The Gold Coast. Get hunkered down. Get ready for the storm of brewing. Gonna have some heavy wave action out there. It's gonna get a little nuts. But everyone will be safe. It'll be a fine weekend. It'll be a mighty fine weekend coming up this weekend. As I talk to you guys through the mirror. But yeah, this place just oozes history. It's kind of nuts. You come in here and you just feel it. You can just feel the amazingness in here. I can't believe the John Denver special was filmed right in here. That's kind of crazy. And it's a big space, but not, I wouldn't figure they would do TV production in here, but they did. Kind of amazing. Make this gimbal work a little bit here. Now you really were wishing you, right? Yeah. You are here through the power of the internet. You are here. Yeah, there was no way we were not gonna not do this. We just had to make sure we had the okay from everyone. And we did! So I'm happy to be pricking you guys this broadcast here. Live here on the Music of Curiosities of Coney Island's YouTube channel. Now, if you haven't subscribed yet, do me a favor. Subscribe. Hit the notification bell, because I don't know when the hell we're going to go live. Other than when we're going to do our shows once a month. We got a great show coming up next month. Or this month, actually. We already hit September. This month got a great show coming up in a couple of weeks. I believe it's going to be another all-female spectacular. Got some really great acts coming up. So if you can't make the Museum of Curiosities, you could watch it live right here. Right here on this YouTube channel. It's kind of amazing. Who is the third young squire in the room? Tell me where you're watching from. Let me give you a shout out. Because it's interactive. That's right. I wish there was a way you guys could buy raffle tickets. But we're working on it. Better yet, you could leave a donation. Leave a donation. As we have the incomparable Tom Waits perform. What a long day. I had a long day. A few more minutes, and we're coming back. A few more minutes. Oscar Fleetwood's in the house. Good to see you, Oscar. Welcome to the Henson Carriage House here in the Upper East Side. Thanks for tuning on in. Just tuning in. We have still have the second half of tonight's performances about to be underway. So hang on in there. We just brought a little bit of the sideshow out here today to the Upper East Side, which is kind of surreal. Kind of surreal. Bringing a little bit of Coney Island out here. So, I'm going to do my best to entertain you people, all right? So, stay tuned. No, I'm not going to drink here with all this equipment here. Don't worry about it. It's all good. Thank you. Anyway, if I have a beer, I'm going to go to sleep, so. Yeah, no, it's all good. The great Norman Blake offering me a beer. Look at that. Yeah, I know. They don't have anything else but the alcohol. Oh, sparkling water. That's good. These mirrors are, like, tripping me out. It's, like, so much fun. These mirrors are so much fun. So much fun to use this to shoot. Let me move around my hands a little bit, move around my arms a little bit here. Limber up for the second half of tonight's performance. And yes, there is still time available to get to our goal. So the link is down below. You can make a donation. And better yet, if you spend more than $50, you get a ticket to opening night on, I believe it's November 16th. It's going to be amazing. You don't want to miss it. Oh, it's going to be so cool. Yeah, I know. Norm's all dressed up, Linda. I'm kind of not used to it. It's kind of amazing. I'm just schlepping over here in a Pnk Vlvt Wtch t-shirt. And by the way, Marissa, if you're watching, Marissa, good to see ya. Marissa, another brain for this Music of Curiosities makes it all happen. Yeah, Norm's all dressed up. Out on the town. Yeah, and out on the town. So we still have performances from Jelly Boy the Clown is here. So you will get to see some Jelly Boy the Clown. Oh my God. But donate. Oh yeah. Yes. Do you want a Pnk Vlvt Wtch t-shirt? I believe you could buy the Pnk Vlvt Wtch t-shirts over at a Coney Island USA, so you gotta have to come on out. Actually, if he comes back around, I'll ask Pnk Vlvt Wtch, where can you get one of these truly limited edition t-shirts? There's not too many of these out and about. But there's definitely a few for sale out there, so we'll make it happen, Linda. We'll make it happen. Not too many of these. I love walking out of the train on the Upper East Side, and everyone's looking at my shirt trying to read it, which is kind of funny. Like, what does that say? It says Coney Island Pnk Vlvt Wtch. And it's in pink font. As Dick talks about the play. I'm starting to memorize the music, which is kind of crazy. That last one into the intergalactic universe. It's one of my faves. The effect that Nikos puts on his guitar is so cool. So good.
Uh-oh. All right, folks.
The Yay!
Is about to begin. Step
time. Do we got to do a showtime?
All right, welcome. So let's work with what we've got. Folks, we are blessed tonight. We have a friend of Coney Island USA, a member of the Box Cutter Collective, based in Brooklyn. A veteran of the Bread and Puppet Theater, who is gonna dole out some magic for us tonight. Clap if you like magic. Folks, without any further ado, the stylings of Tom Cunningham.
Yay!
Great, thank you. Thank you, Brendan.
Thank you.
Thank you, Dick. Thank you, everyone. Thank you. Now, I know we just clapped, but can I see a show of hands? Who here likes magic?
Yeah.
Okay, good. Some of you like magic. That's good. Well, you're in for a treat, because somebody who's going to come to the stage now, he's one of the top five magicians working in the world today. He's one of the best. And I stand by that statement, otherwise I wouldn't have said it. And of course, obviously I'm talking about the great Gene St. John's. Now, if you're not familiar with his work, I pity you, but don't fret, because you're going to get to see what he's all about very soon. And let me tell you what he's all about. He's all about juggling. Sword swallowing.
Yeah.
And in 1997, using only the power of his mind, Gene St. John's convinced a woman to marry him. Right, that's right. So he's going to blow your minds, literally, and I mean that, and I guarantee you, your minds will be blown. And if you're not convinced that the act that you're about to see is hands down the greatest magic act that you've ever seen, I personally will enter your home and I will fold your dirty laundry. That is a promise I make to you. Thank you.
All right.
Now, without any further ado, please welcome the one, the only, Gene St. Oh, sorry. That's my cell phone. This is embarrassing. I should have turned it off before the show started, but I forgot. I'm so embarrassed. Let me just answer it and see what this is about. I'm sure it's nothing, but this will only take a minute. Hello? Gene? Where are you? I'm introducing you right now. You're dropping out of the show so you can get a hair perm? Well, Gene St. John's, this is the most unprofessional poppycock I've ever heard. No, you listen. Gene, I'm tired of this. You do this every time. I'm humiliated.
I will never forgive you for this, Jean St. John's. I want you out of my life for good. Okay, bye-bye. Oh, what will I do? Who needs them? I'll do my own magic act.
Yeah.
I do better magic than him anyway. I just need a little bit of music.
Thank you.
And the mother's just standing there.
Oh, damn it.
Oh.
It's fun.
Let them do the trick.
Oh!
Tom Cunningham. Take just a moment here. The next performer you are about to see, you might recognize, but you've never seen anything quite like this, folks. Mr. Rob Romeo.
Okay, what I'm going to attempt to do for you right now is a mixture of things, and I hope you enjoy them. We're going to simultaneously tell you the harrowing story of my life while throwing several chickens into the lawnmower. I hope you enjoy it. I remember when I was just a very little boy, my house caught on fire. I'll never forget the look on my father's face as he snatched me up in his arms and we raced from the burning building. And I sat there on the pavement shivering in my pajamas as I watched my whole world go up in flames. And I said to myself, do you know what I said to myself? You know what I said to myself?
No! What'd you say?
I said to myself, is that all there is to fire?
Yeah.
Is that all there is? Is that all there is? If that's all there is, my friends, then there must be dancing. Let's bring out the booze! And have a ball! If that's all there is, if that's all. Oh, I'm not allowed to smoke in Henson House, am I?
On stage, it's me.
Then one day, when I was 12 years old, my father took me to a circus. The greatest show on earth! Yeah. There were clowns, elephants, dancing bears, and a lady in pretty pink tights that flew above our heads. And I sat there, watching. I couldn't help but think that there was something missing. I didn't know what it was, so I said to myself, do you know what I said to myself?
Hey.
Do you know what I said to myself?
What did you say?
Do you know what I said to myself?
Hey.
Do you know what I said to myself?
What did you say?
I said to myself, is that all there is to a circus?
Yeah.
Is that all there is? Is that all there is? If that's all there is, my friends, then there must be dancing. Let's bring out the booze, and we'll have them all. If that's all there is, if that's all.
No way.
Then one day, I fell in love with the most beautiful girl in the entire world. We would take long walks and just sit there for hours, gazing into each other's eyes. And then one day, she went away, and I thought I would die. I said to myself,
what'd you say?
Do you know what I said to myself? 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 I said, I said to myself, is that all there is to love? Is that all there is? Is that all there is? If that's all there is, my friends, then there must be dancing. Let's bring out the booze, and we'll have them all. If that's all there is, if that's all. Love. Fuck. And I'll tell you something else. It's real deal. Pain in the ass. Now, folks, I know what you're thinking, sitting there in your chairs, online, judging me. I bet you're saying to yourself, if he's so miserable all the time, why wouldn't he just end it all, you know? Hang myself! Uh-uh. Not me. I'm not ready for that final disappointment yet. But I know just as sure as I'm standing here that when that moment comes and I've taken my last breath, you know what I'll say to myself?
What?
What are you gonna say?
You know what I'll say to myself?
No idea!
Do you know what I'll say to myself? Do you know what I'll say to myself? I'll say to myself, is that all there is to death? Is that all there is? Is that all there is? If that's all there is, my friends, then there must be dancing. Go on, dance! We'll bring out the booze! And we'll have them all! If that's all there is! If that's all, if that's all there is, that's all.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Thank you, Rob Romeo. Folks, if you want to find more of Rob Romeo, check out Twisted Circus Cabaret. He manages it, and they perform all over. We have for you one final performer for the evening. This fellow is an international sensation, a staple of the Coney Island Circus Sideshow, a founding member of the Squiddling Brothers Circus Sideshow. I know him. You're gonna love him. Jelly Boy the Clown.
Yeah.
I'm going to do something for you today that I've been told is very difficult to watch because it involves my eyeballs, my nostrils, and my throat.
Oh, that's all?
Do you ever go to one of those doctors? Well, I've been to them a couple of times and they just they told me everything was going to be okay. I also got a pair of nipple clamps. But I only found one of the pair, so I got a single nipple clamp. And I'm going to put it right here. And then we'll get some music going. This is my friend Bunny Bear. This is Bunny Bear, the butt plug bunny. He's a sword puppet. And he's very delighted to be here today. Hi, everybody. Dreams that would awake me. an opportunity to have some therapy for yourselves. This is the cheapest form of therapy you're going to be offered in this demented society. It's a little game that we like to call Staple the Clown! So in your pockets, you will find money. If you can't find any money in your pockets, I'm sure you can find some money in someone else's pocket. People will help each other in this game. Staple as much money to my body as humanly possible. Now, we can start in some soft places and go to some difficult places, or we could start in some difficult places and go to some soft places. That's entirely up to you. For just $5, you can staple me anywhere you like on my body.
Anywhere.
Anywhere. Within reason.
How much if it's not within reason?
If you want to get weird, if you want to get kinky, if you want to get a little bit twisted, for $10, let's say you could staple my armpit, for example. $20, you could staple a nipple, a face cheek, or an ass cheek. For $50, you could staple my head. For $100, we could...
it's a private room. You know?
We can do it for art. Art. Who wants to start us off? Take some money out of your pockets. Come on up here. One person does it, and then everybody's going to want to do it. It's so much fun. Come on up. Don't be shy. Have some fun with a staple clown. Where would you staple a clown if you had a choice to do it?
Screw you, Dad!
Oh, yeah. Look at that. Now I realize that not everybody is going to want to staple me because some people don't want to hurt me. Now we're going to pass some masks around the room. You don't have to put money in, but you can't take money out. If we collect $100, we will end the show by stapling a sensitive part of my body, and all the money goes to money free.
Stay long. The next number is 628-674. 6-7-5.
6-7-5.
Got it. Hey!
What do you want,
Pnk Vlvt
Wtch?
You know what?
Hey!
Hey!
Thanks.
Oh my god, the twins!
Next ticket.
And then three tarot readings.
Yep. Right there.
Baboo.
All right, onward. We have probably 6-2-8. And it's 6-2-8, 7-4-1.
7-4-1.
6-2-8, 7-4-1.
Oh, again! Again!
Hey,
uh-oh. Two Marie Robins. Oh. Yeah!
Strange but true. Folks, the next number is
628-667. Ooh.
628-667.
667. Oh, Pnk Vlvt Wtch!
Alright.
Yeah!
We still have. She has. I'm going to take you three
tarot readings. All right. Mix that up for you, sir. We have other goodies, folks. Let's see. 628-752.
752.
628-752. Yay! Wow, you think this is like an inside job here, gentlemen? It's perfect. Postcards, t-shirts, MoMA tickets.
Tarot readings, MoMA tickets, and the puppetry show.
The puppetry show?
Yeah.
Oh, you get to come to the show. I love that.
Investigate. Look at the t-shirt.
Nice. Can you go ahead? I just can't. All right, take a time. Oh, these are nice. Should I just get one
of them? Yeah. There are vintage Coney Island cards. While Jennifer's considering, how about 628-714?
714.
628-714.
Yay!
Going once.
Somebody said I got it. Yeah, who has it? Has it again?
628-714.
All right. There you go.
Yeah. What's your pleasure?
Call another number.
So
we have
2 shirts left,
3 postcards,
3 tarot readings by me,
1 pair of tickets for the
puppet show, and 3 pairs of tickets to
Whoa, yeah!
Next up.
There we go.
628-641.
No whammies.
Who's still here? Hey! All these people double dipping. Right? Next.
Make house call.
Oh man, we gotta get through this. 628-784. 628-784. 784.
All right, Betsy Brookman. What do I
get? Yay!
784.
Yay!
Good. Thank you, Betsy.
Yay! It went underneath Sue somewhere. 712.
Wait, what? 628-712. Going once. Twice.
All right. Oh, gentlemen. That's a gentleman right there.
Okay, we're after it. Next ticket, 628-696.
696.
628-696.
Tyler, Tyler, Tyler.
Yay! Yay!
Next, 628-721.
721?
628-721.
Nope.
No.
721.
Is
that
a yes?
I have it when you can pick again.
Yay!
Body wrap.
Yeah.
Body wrap, though. Next.
628-693. 693.
628-693.
Someone must
have it. 693. Yeah! Play the lottery!
Make them
take his. All right. Yay! Take one. Perfect. Alright, next. We have a t-shirt left. Two postcards. Two pair of tickets to Malma and a tarot reading. 628-802. Next call, next number, 628-799.
Yay!
T-shirt, postcards,
moment ticket,
guitar. All right. 628-646,
we're so close. 628-646.
No. We got a winner!
Yay! Oh my god.
Yes.
Oh, thank
wow,
God.
That's me. Come on now.
Yay!
Hey, and you win the knife, too.
Yay!
Only three items left, folks. Last three. Here we go. 628-734. Coney Island vintage postcard 628-755. 628-755.
Yeah, yeah,
oh,
I have that.
Yay!
Thank you for joining us at the beautiful Henson Carriage House.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much to Ibex Puppetry for allowing us to bring the freaky.
Yes.
Yeah. We can't wait to see you in November when we premiere Bloody Brains in a Jukebox, the rock opera.
And most of these people have opening night tickets already.
Right. Thank you.
Yay.
Thank you for your support. Make sure to grab your funny face, build your own puppet by the door.
Absolutely.
Keep in touch. Watch us on social media as things roll out to learn all about the progress of the show. We will see you very soon. Thank you so much.
Well, thanks for tuning on in, Laurie and Linda and Oscar and everyone else in the house. Wasn't that fun? I'll see you guys from the Upper East Side. Good night, Mrs. Calabash, wherever you are.